All right, good morning, happy Sunday. I am in my pajamas, in bed, because again, it's a Sunday. Here we are, I just want to answer a quick question, which is better, or what's the difference, or what do I like more, Math Mammoth or Math with Confidence? Because I've used both for quite a few months for both of them. And what did I think? Okay. Actually, a couple years for, actually, now that I think about it, for both of them. Okay, first off, of course, we have products of the day. We have, this is Jump by Melon Rind. So it's numbers 1 to 10. And what it is it's pretty simple. Have you ever played Speed? So if there's a 2 down there, you can put a 1 or a 3 down, right? I'll spare you, but if you've played Speed, you have 2 piles and everyone. Anyway, it's supposed to be kind of simpler for kids, the 1 to 10 instead of using a regular deck. But you can use a regular deck to play Speed, but that's all it is. And it's kind of cool because, you know, what goes on top of a 7? You can put down a 6 and you can put a 5. Okay, so that is Jump by Melon Rind. Next up we got, I want to show you these. These are three-corner addition and subtraction. So take a look at this. You covered, so it shows you, it introduces you to families. So 12, so, you know, 18 minus 6 is 12. And 18 minus 12 is 6. So they're families. Okay, so on the back too, you got some more. 60 minus 12 is 4, or, you know, 60 minus what equals 4 is how I do it with my kindergartner. He's advanced at math, don't worry, because my other child can't do this. So 60 minus 12 is 4, so whatever way you want to do it. But anyway, that's what they are. They're three-corner addition and subtraction cards. So kind of cool. Lastly is like my favorite math game, and we have quite a few. This is Moby Kids. It is awesome. So these are all in the center. Someone's green and someone's blue, and you just pick up these, and whoever uses all their letters first, or all their numbers first, in a proper equation. So let's just pretend that's a proper equation, and then I would go 7 minus, this I can make anything, so 7 minus, I don't know, 5, but to use all my green tiles, and if I do that, I win, if I beat the whoever using blue tiles. Okay, and that is Moby Kids. So, some of my favorite math products. Okay, so what do I like better? Math Mammoth. I was trying to find the Math with Confidence so I could flip through to show you again, but I'll either put it on the screen or I'll put a link at the end so that you can see in depth. The last video I did about gifted kids shows you, a gifted and non-gifted both, shows you really how I use Math Mammoth. Now, I have switched between Math Mammoth and Math with Confidence for quite a few years, and in the end I came back to Math Mammoth. Let me give you the rundown of the differences between them. Okay, so Math with Confidence, it is, you're talking 5 to 10 minutes teacher prep before you sit down, and then it's 10 to 30 minutes lessons because you're just playing a game with your kids. It's pure bonding with them. And then after, they do independently a one-page worksheet. So Math with Confidence is Spiral and Mastery. It's one of the only programs it is. It's a very in-depth program written by a woman who, she has dual degrees from Harvard in mathematics and education. So I think it's a great program. I mean, it is, it's great. It's very gentle, very slow. You do one lesson per math day. Now, I prefer personally Math Mammoth. That's it. Again, both great. I've toyed between the two. Just for, I told you about my gifted son, just because, so Math Mammoth, you decide how long the lessons are. There's no prep. You just sit down, open the book, and wherever you left off the day before, that's where you keep going. So there's no assigned lessons. You decide, okay, today we're gonna do, and then this is what I do, and then I just, you know, choose 3 from this section, because we're working on addition, all different types of addition now in the first part of the book. Okay, choose 3 from this part. Okay, choose 3 from this part. And then if they need help, okay, we'll do more in that part. We'll do more in that part. We'll do more in that part. And if they don't, depending on which child I'm working with, okay, then we go through it faster. Okay, we don't need to do it. Now, it's surprisingly dynamic. I understand it's not play-based, but it's surprisingly dynamic for just paper. Now, there are the links and stuff, and there are a few games you can do, but not much. Not much. Both programs cost about the same, if you're wondering. They're about $50 each for the year. Math with Confidence is Spiral Mastery, as I told you. Math Mammoth is Mastery, which just means that it's, you're gonna stay on addition until you've nailed addition, and then you're gonna move on to subtraction. But you can always go back. You're not meant to do every single question. You can always go back and be like, okay, let's do a refresher on addition. So in that sense, it can
can become spiral as well. So it just depends. Again, both brilliant programs. They're both great. There are a lot of video links for Math Mammoth as well. I just haven't used any. I haven't needed any at this point, so I haven't even tried them. So I can't say to whether they're good or not, but I just love that it's no prep. We sit down, we open it up. Now for my child that has trouble sitting still, there's ADHD, ODD, he has trouble sitting still. Again, I still use Math Mammoth, even though we had a great time with Math with Confidence, because he's so advanced, I wanna see what he knows and I wanna keep moving him through the levels to go up other levels. So for that, what I do is, he just has really short lessons every day. Like, he's still really young. So we just do, and it's just one of those things that, oh yes, you know, you wanna play your iPad. I totally get that. I understand that. This is just one of the list of chores that we have gotta go through. You gotta do some math. And then I sprinkle it up, like I would use these or something, or ask him some math questions, or, you know, I've talked in a few other videos about the different math challenges I do with him. But again, he's still young, so I just prefer Math Mammoth just because it's no prep. We could sit down, we could go through it, and it's all laid out there. And because I was overwhelmed with math myself, I always tell them, hey, I'm learning math too, so check my work. And because there's enough questions, I can do some and they could check my work. But it is great because it's got a lot of bright colors, and it's got a lot of, it shows you how to do the questions, like it, with pictorial samples sometimes. And so I really love it, but I love both. I love both, but my preference right now is Math Mammoth. But when they were younger, we did do Math with Confidence. And maybe when they're older, I might go back to it. I'm not sure. I can't speak to future years because I did also sign up to some online math programs. And I started using those and then realized, no, because he's too quick for that. My one son, he's too quick. I want to be able to look at math and be like, okay, can you do this type of addition? Can you do this type of addition? Show me you can do this type, because then we can move on. You know, so that way I have a lot more control, I guess, over the curriculum and what I'm teaching than just here's one lesson. We sit down, we have to do one lesson before we go to the next lesson. Which would work fine for my other child. It's just, it's personal preference. So I hope that helped, and I hope you gleaned something from it. If you have any more questions of what you'd like me to make videos about, because I've bought every single curriculum of every single type possible, I think. Not every single one, I'm sure there's some I haven't. But go ahead and leave a question down and I will give you my opinion, which you can totally disagree with it. That is fine too. And take care and have
peace, like the vibe.
Yes.
And hit the bell for notifications.